Well, the 2024 Oscar nominations came out, and a whole lot of people were upset about Barbie's lack of nominations, particularly in the Best Director and Best Actress category, where both director Greta Gerwig and actress Margot Robbie were respectively missing. However, is this so-called outrage really warranted? In my opinion, not really, no. Now wait a second and hear me out before you click off the video. I'd like to preface everything I'm about to say by letting you guys know that I very much enjoyed Barbie. I've actually seen it 4 times, 2 of which were in theaters, actually. And I'll say this, I've actually enjoyed the movie more and more every time I've seen it. I'll be honest, when I first saw it, I wasn't too hot on it. I liked it, but I definitely didn't love it. That being said, I still thought it was super cool seeing everyone dress up in pink and going out to see it and supporting the movie, especially the reception to it. I was happy to see so many people getting behind Barbie and being super emotionally moved by it. I just didn't really have that same visceral reaction, unfortunately. But then again, on my first viewing, I saw it in an absolutely explosive theater where every single line from the movie got a standing ovation from the crowd. So perhaps that kind of bombastic atmosphere took away from the movie the first go around. And normally, you know, I really like rowdy crowds. I love when the whole theater is involved and actively cheering, laughing, gasping, oohing and aahing or whatever. That's one of the main reasons I even go to the movie theater. But that particular experience was just a little too much for me. I truly don't think I've ever gone to a theater and had that level of non-stop laughter, cheering, and what have you from the audience. And I think that just speaks to how well received the movie was with audiences. There's a reason why it was the biggest movie of 2023 and why so many people are still talking about it today with the nominations. But again, I've seen it 4 times, and each time that experience has gotten quieter and quieter, which I think has allowed me to better take in the movie. I got more and more out of it each time, noticing little details here and there with every viewing. By the second viewing, I already knew that I kind of liked the movie quite a bit, but especially by the fourth, I knew I was completely locked in. I knew I liked this movie. Obviously. I mean, what kind of person watches a movie 4 times that they don't like? In 1 year, no less. And I'll say it, I liked Barbie more than Oppenheimer. And I knew I liked it more than Oppenheimer the first time I saw them both on opening weekend. And I knew I still preferred it after watching both movies 4 times as well. Which means, yes, I've also watched Oppenheimer 4 times. And I unfortunately can't say that I enjoyed the movie more and more with each viewing as I can with Barbie. And all that being said, I still don't really agree with the so-called outrage surrounding Barbie and its Oscar nominations, or perhaps lack thereof. Not sure why news outlets want to use that word in particular, but as I'm sure everyone's aware of now, Greta Gerwig and Margot Robbie were still nominated. It's not like they were completely snubbed. Greta was nominated for Best Adapted Screenplay, which she co-wrote with her husband Noah Baumbach, and Margot Robbie served as executive producer on Barbie, which means that she'll be up for Best Picture if the movie wins. And this is something I'm not sure a lot of people know about, but you know how a lot of the time when you see a movie win Best Picture at the Oscars, and you see all these random people accepting the awards, and not the director or the cast members? I mean, just last year when this dude walked up to the stand to accept the Best Picture Oscar for Everything Everywhere All at Once, I remember a bunch of people online were like, "Who the fuck is that guy?
Who the fuck is that? Who the fuck is that?
Where are the Daniels? Who is this random guy on the stage that I've never seen before?" Well, he was the producer of the film. I mean, every time you see these random people accepting these awards, these are the producers of the film. I mean, I want to say 99% of the time, the producers are the one accepting the award for Best Picture, which is why people are saying that Margot Robbie is still nominated for Barbie, even though she wasn't nominated for Best Actress. And I think you could argue, lots of people would, I'd imagine, that the Best Picture Oscar is the most prestigious award at every single Oscar ceremony, which I guess would mean that Margot Robbie could be accepting the biggest award of the night if Barbie wins. Which leads me to my next point, and I know it's gonna piss a lot of people off and gonna make me seem like a huge hypocrite considering I just said I liked Barbie more than Oppenheimer a couple minutes ago, but I don't really think Barbie should have been nominated for Best Picture.
You need to leave!
And again, I also don't think my show should have been nominated for Best Picture either, even though I still like that movie too. I like both of these movies. I just thought there were a couple movies that could have taken their place that, in my opinion, were more deserving and more moving films. Of course, it's all subjective, it's all just my opinion, but films like The Iron Claw or Godzilla Minus One, for example.
The only thing that matters to me.
And even though I said I preferred Barbie over Oppenheimer, I still think Oppenheimer is more deserving of the Best Picture nomination, but that's a whole other video's worth of discussion, and that's not really what this video's about, and I'm not gonna get into it in this video. That's something for another time. Besides, I tend to enjoy movies that aren't in the Oscar race more than ones that are. I feel like my channel is pretty evident of that.
I don't know. I also just don't really care about the Oscars. I feel like they kind of tend to be a lot of pretentious movies that are just obviously trying to win awards. You know what I'm talking about. And I don't really like pretentious movies that much. I'm not saying I'm above them. I'm just saying I'm monkey-brained. Not saying that you're a monkey for liking Barbie either. I need to stop talking about this. Let's move on.
But back to what I was saying, I don't think Margot Robbie should have been nominated for Best Actress.
You piece of shit! You fucking goddamn fucker! Listen, fuckhead! You have fucking crossed the line.
Of course, again, it's just my opinion, but I didn't really think Margot Robbie's performance in Barbie was Best Actress worthy. It was a good performance for sure, but I wouldn't have had it in place for anybody else who was nominated in the category.
Hell, I would have really liked to see Greta Lee up there as well from Past Lives.
And I definitely do not think that Ryan Gosling should have been nominated for Best Supporting Actor. Listen, I love Ryan Gosling. I literally have a mini shrine of him in my apartment and even have his autograph alongside Emma Stone's for La La Land. I love Ryan Gosling.
I've been championing this man ever since I saw Blue Valentine back in 2011.
And I'm really happy to see him finally become the A-list actor that Hollywood's been trying to make him for years. I truly mean that. I fucking love this man, alright? But I think even he's a bit confused by his own award season this year for the character of Ken. I mean, let's not forget how he reacted at the Critics' Choice Awards. Gosling gave a super fun performance. He was one of the best parts of the movie overall. I mean, I don't think anybody's going to disagree with that. But it was just a really lighthearted, goofy performance. And I don't really think that warrants an Oscar win. I'm not saying there wasn't depth to the character or to his acting. I just think that there are so many other people that could have done better in this category. Though, I do think that Greta Gerwig could have gotten a nomination for Best Director. But I'm not mad that she didn't. And I'd imagine that she's not mad either. I mean, we all know that Gerwig's a badass. She's been Oscar nominated 4 times since 2018. Not to mention the tons of other awards she's actually taken home from other award shows over the years too. Not having the Best Director Oscar isn't going to invalidate her from being an amazing filmmaker. So I don't exactly agree with the quote unquote outrage, I'm going to keep saying that, about this movie. Still though, obviously an Oscar nod would have been nice. I will not disagree to that, but I don't really think that it's something to be actively pressed about. And just to be clear, because I unfortunately have to make this extra clear in all my videos, I'm not saying my opinion is fact or above anybody else's. If you disagree, that's awesome. No one's more correct than the other when talking about opinions on art. Which would kind of coincide in another thing that I'm seeing a lot of people fail to mention about this whole Oscar nomination fiasco, is that there simply isn't enough slots for everybody. People like to see movies, especially during the award season, as director's projects. Like, how can a movie be nominated for Best Picture and not Best Director? I've seen that so much this year for Barbie. I mean, let's just think about the math. If you have 10 Best Picture nominations and only 5 Best Director nominations, obviously there's going to be some directors who aren't nominated in that category. I really think people are failing to understand that point. Like, there just isn't enough slots in the director category for everyone in the Best Picture category. And I don't understand why there isn't the same support for all these directors in Best Picture who weren't nominated for Best Director. But it's only really for Greta Gerwig here. Like, at least the, you know, the vocal majority. I mean, Maestro was nominated for Best Picture, but Bradley Cooper wasn't nominated for Best Director. Holdovers was nominated for Best Picture, but Alexander Payne wasn't nominated for Best Director. American Fiction was nominated for Best Picture, but Cord Jefferson wasn't nominated for Best Director. Past Lives was nominated for Best Picture, but Celine Song wasn't nominated for Best Director either. Or what about last year with Women Talking, directed by Sarah Pauley? Her movie got nominated for Best Picture, but she wasn't nominated for Best Director. And there wasn't at all an outcry for her and Women Talking like there is now for Barbie. So how come there isn't the same level of support for these directors getting their respective nominations comparatively to Greta Gerwig and Barbie? I mean, we know why. It's because it's Barbie. It was the biggest movie of last year. It meant a lot to so many people because a lot of people were able to see it. Whereas something like Women Talking or Past Lives, while both good movies that are just as emotionally resonant, in my opinion, made only fractions of what Barbie did, making them much smaller, much less seen movies. So there wasn't the same level of outcry for them. Which makes sense, yes,
but at that point it just feels like favoritism, you know? I just think it's unfortunate that instead of creating a positive atmosphere and celebrating the women that are nominated this year at the Oscars, we're too busy creating a negative one and being upset at those that weren't.
And let's say Gerwig was nominated for Best Director. That means one of these lovely directors who put in just as much work and deserve just as much recognition wouldn't be getting the nomination. I guess, except Nolan and Scorsese, because the Academy was always going to nominate these two. But again, you see what I'm getting at. It's kind of just blatant favoritism by audiences at that point, in my opinion, to eliminate someone else for Greta. I mean, who else would you take out for Gerwig in this situation and have it not be horribly offensive? The reality is that not everyone is going to be up for a nomination, and that's okay. It doesn't diminish the value of their work. Instead, let's be happy for those who did get nominated for their work, and be happy that Greta Gerwig and Margot Robbie were still nominated and will be represented at the Oscars. Let's just enjoy movies for what they are, guys. I feel like I say this in every other video of mine. Yeah, winning awards is cool and all, but at the end of the day, just because something doesn't win an award doesn't make it any less seen or loved. I mean, everyone has seen Barbie. Everyone knows that it's a good movie. Everyone knows its importance. An award is not going to change that. Especially as normal, everyday audience members, I don't think we should be outwardly upset on somebody else's behalf because they didn't get nominated for a movie, and saying that they should have been nominated over somebody else. I mean, I always think about and revisit this Ethan Hawke interview.
Our country turns everything into a competition. They want to tell you what's its score on Rotten Tomatoes, how much box office did it make. And when I was growing up, those things didn't exist, and you could just absorb a movie for how it meant to you. There's no game to win. You know, that's not what art is.
Guys, let's just be thankful and happy for everyone who is nominated and be excited for all the movies that are going to come out this year that'll be nominated next year. Let's take it one step at a time here. And that's it from me, guys. For more reviews, video essays, retrospectives, and the likes, check out my channel and subscribe for more content. Other than that, thank you guys very much. I hope you liked the video. I'll see you next time.